Hey everyone, this is Joel, and I'm going to show you a quick way to create an online help ticket system for students. Most people think that you would be able to have students access Helpdesk to submit technology requests, but our system is not open for students. They do not have Eduphoria accounts to log in. So another application to consider using would be Formspace. Inside Formspace, you can create different types of forms that would be available for inside your district access. That would be district and school forms. But you also have the ability to create web forms, which would be available for anyone who has internet access to be able to select a custom link that's available for your form and be able to submit information without an Eduphoria login. And so you can create a web form as needed. I'm gonna reference you to go to the Eduphoria community. When you click on Eduphoria community, you wanna click this refresh button. This will refresh all of the folders and all of the documents that are available. Our team at Eduphoria has created a new folder called Crisis Response District Forms. Again, if you're not seeing that form when you click Eduphoria Community, you must click the refresh button. That will refresh your list of folders as well as the documents inside. Once you have access to this Crisis Response District Forms, if you click on it, we have a few forms in here. I'm going to reference and use this particular form, which is Remote Technical Support Ticket Form. It is a very simple form for your users to access, asks very basic questions, and it has these red asterisks that indicate they are required questions. So when you see this document and you want to use it as kind of to build off of or to use the form as is, you will click Import Document To, and from the list that appears, you're going to select Web Form. Again, the reason you want to select Web Form is you need the form to be available for users outside of your district or school to access. So I'm going to click Web Forms and import that document. And then it will show in your Manage tab under Web Forms. It shows twice here because I created the form. It's going to bring in the form that was imported so that now you can access the settings of that form to make your changes. Click on the Questions tab if you would like to edit the contents of the form that's already here. So for example, I can click Edit over here, and here's my list of items. You can make changes, you can delete a row item that would be selectable. You can enter text, like click here and type in other text that you want, and then click the plus button to add more list items to be selected. Click on Show Options if you want to make it a required question or not. If it's multiple choice, meaning you can select one of the options. Multiple selection, which means you can select multiple items, or a drop-down list, just like you're seeing here, where it's a list of items, but you can only select one option as well. And then you can also include an other option, allowing the user to have a text field where they can enter in other information. Click Finish. You can, like I said, you can add more questions. You can move questions up and down the page. So for example, I have a question here saying email address so we can contact you. If I wanted to include another field for collecting phone information, I can select a text question, click on Show Options, make it required. I can make the field larger or smaller, and click Finished. Then when I want to move this question up, I need to click on Move Questions and Pages, select the item, move it up one or move it up another one if I need, and click Save, and it moves the question up above the other one there. Workflow is where you're going to define what happens behind the scenes once the user submits the form. Recipients is where you can identify a user who's going to collect all of the forms after it has gone through the workflow process. Workflow is where you define the steps for the process. You can have an approval step, which means it goes to a user, and before it continues through the flow, that user has to approve or deny. If they deny, it stops the entire flow. Notification means they receive an email notification. When you're rolling this out for the current situations you have going on in your district, notification may be the only step that you need, where it's going to email a group, a staff member. So you may want to have it go to the particular staff member who is managing your devices that are checked out. If it's a group of technicians, then you want to define that group in system management. It's one of our other applications in the system that you would define your technology group who is going to be receiving the notification as that group. Once you've identified your group, click Save. It's going to put the information for the group members that were selected as the notification step. You can have as many workflow steps as you need. Once you've defined your workflow, this tab can be closed. Go to settings, some important settings that you can set. You can require a CAPTCHA, which is when the person clicks the link to access the form, it will have a code. It's a way of preventing bots from using the form to put in fake data. And then this last part here is if you're creating a document but you want someone else to manage it, you can select that user. This last tab is notification. This is very important. This is where it's going to create your URL. You can take that URL and put that on a website that you have already created for your public facing. I would also recommend if you're doing a mobile device initiative and handing out devices to users who are taking them home, I would recommend copying the URL and using something to create QR codes. And also shortened URLs. I would create a sticker, basically, of the QR code and the shortened URL that would go to this tech support ticket form, and then print out those stickers, and before you hand out the devices, attach that sticker to the device to make it easier for your users to access if they're having device issues. It's just an easier way for them to access help on the device itself than having to go search for a link or a website for that information. After you have everything ready and it's saved, you will want to click Publish. It's going to ask, are you wanting to commit the changes? We're going to say yes. After you've published, you'll want to make the form active. Then you can use the link to send to your users, embed in a web page or link off of a web page. Use the QR code or the shortened URL address so that your users can access that form.